Hey guys, Saki here from Saki Tech, and in today's video, we are going to be taking a look at the OnePlus 6 and the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. And in this video specifically, I'm going to focus on three features, software features that the OnePlus 6 took from the Samsung Galaxy S9 and made part of its software system. Now, of course, the title of the video says that it stole it, but stealing is not necessarily a bad thing when it comes to software functionality. The more you take from another phone that works well, the better the other phone becomes. So I want to make sure that the OnePlus 6 users and owners do not get mad at the title, but it is what it is. As you know, OnePlus 6 does not hide the fact that it copies stuff from other phones. And let me give you a quick hint on that right there. All right, so let's not get too mad, but let's take a look at what I'm actually talking about. Now, the first thing I noticed over here was because the OnePlus 6 now has a very large display, there's a software navigation bar at the bottom over here, the back key, the home key, and the recents key. And as you can see, we have the same situation over here. So Samsung allows you to make modifications to the navigation bar. And I've noticed that now the OnePlus phones that have the software keys also allow you to do this with the newer Oxygen OS updates. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So let's go to the settings on each smartphone over here. So let's go to the settings over here as well. Let's go to display and let's go to navigation bar over here. And with the OnePlus, you go to customization, you go to buttons, and you go to navigation bar and gestures. So on the top here, I've noticed that we have the hide navigation bar option now available. So by default, the navigation bar is always fixed. So let's do that. So it remains fixed in place, and the same is available over here with the show and hide button. So with this one, if I do hide navigation bar and if I tap on this, I now have the option to hide this navigation bar to get a full screen view. So if I tap this guy, it disappears. And if I want to bring it back, I just go like this and it comes right up. The same applies to the Samsung Galaxy S9 and the S9 Plus, and also the S8 and the S8 Plus. And of course, it is something that I saw on the S9s before I saw it on the actual OnePlus smartphones. So if I tap on this one over here, again, we have a button here. I can tap that button twice, double tap it, it disappears. And if I bring it back up, it goes like that. If I tap it again, two times, it locks in place. Same with this guy. So if I pull this up and if I tap it one time, it locks in place. If I tap it again, it disappears and I can pull it out right up. The only difference is over here, I tap once, over here, I double tap. So double tap, disappears, bring it back up, double tap, gets fixed into place. Okay, so that's number one thing. And let's talk about the next software feature that the OnePlus 6 seems to have taken from the Samsung Galaxy smartphone. Now, this one is an easy one. This is actually just double tap to bring up the camera. So your phone can be turned off anytime. The screen could be off. It could be in your pocket. You could be looking at something or whatever. And let's say that you saw something and you want to quickly take a picture of that thing. So you can quickly launch the camera without having to unlock your smartphone simply by double tapping the power button. And boom, the camera comes right up for a quick shot. Same applies over here, double tap, boom, camera is right over here. Okay, I'll let you know one thing. When I double tap this one, it seems that the camera launches a little bit faster than the one on this one. So if I double tap here, it also launches very quickly, but this one is a little bit faster. But again, this is a feature that the OnePlus 6 took from the Samsung Galaxy smartphones. Now, the final thing I'm going to talk about is the game mode. So Samsung phones have had the game mode for a while, and it's been refined over and over. And right now, we probably have one of the best game modes that is built into a smartphone on the Galaxy smartphones. But when the OnePlus 6 was announced, they also mentioned a game mode. So let's take a look at these game modes and see what they do. With the Samsung Galaxy, it's also a game mode slash game launcher. So you can basically have a game launcher that categorizes all the games in one place. It is this app right here. You have to enable this in the settings. So let's go inside, and that's what it looks like. It's got all the games in here, and you have a bunch of buttons at the bottom that you can use to make modifications. And of course, you can tap on over here. You can go to the settings, extra modifications here. But the thing with the game mode is when you actually run a game, you get a menu that allows you to record gameplay, take screenshots, and also disable notifications and things like that. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So if I launch this game over here, Sniper, at the bottom here, if the game mode is enabled, you'll see a button. And if you tap that button, you get a bunch of options. You can play games in full screen. You can enable things like no alerts during game. You can have hard press home button lock. and all these different options. And of course, when you're actually playing the game, you can also do gameplay record and stuff like that. And of course, on the top, you have the settings icon. You can tap on that. It'll take you into the actual game tools settings. And so you have a bunch of game tools and a game mode built into the Samsung. And now we are seeing that there's a game mode also in the OnePlus 6. So let's take a look at that one. So let's go to settings. This is going to be all the way at the bottom. You go to advanced over here, and then you're going to look for the gaming mode. You tap on this one, and it's right there. Again, you have a couple options here. You have things like blocking notifications that this one also had. You have the gaming battery saver that this one also had. If you remember, when I go to the game launcher over here, at the bottom here, you can tap this icon, and that changes the performance mode for your smartphone as you desire. But over here with this one, again, you can block notifications. You can do the battery saver over here if you have to. So if you pick the low option, the resolution of a game is going to get limited. It's not going to apply to all the games, but some games. But if you do high, the resolution and FPS of games will be limited. So if you want maximum experience, you want to make sure that it is disabled so it doesn't limit the resolution or the frames per second. Okay, and then you can also do automatic brightness, disable automatic brightness, which means if you have auto brightness set up on your phone, then you can come and enable this so the auto brightness option doesn't mess up your gameplay. So your gameplay has a static brightness. It doesn't dynamically switch back and forth. So again, that's a good option. And you have the network boost option, which this one has as well. So those are the two gaming modes on both of these smartphones. And remember, with this one, when you launch a game, you get that thing right over here, and from here you can make all these modifications. And with this one, you have to go to the settings and enable these things. I kind of like this a little bit better. It looks a little bit more cleaner. But this one is, again, as usual with Samsung smartphones, more feature rich. So far, those are the only three things I noticed that were on the Samsung smartphones that seem to have trickled on the OnePlus smartphones. So again, nothing to get mad about here. As a matter of fact, the more features get added to the OnePlus 6, the better it becomes from a software perspective. All right, if I did miss anything, just let me know down below. If I was wrong about something, also let me know down below. And of course, make sure to subscribe to Saki Tech and give this video a thumbs up. And make sure to follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook for the latest updates. Guys, have a fantastic day.